Usually.
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to thank organizers at Harvard for giving me this opportunity. Oh, yeah, well, so I'm very happy to give a talk here. So today I'm going to talk about totally automatable database. And in the first place, I will roughly explain what the totally automatable database is. So this part is very vague. So please do not ask me some technical questions, I beg you. So I'm going to start with Hopf algebra of motivated multiple databases, more than a few, where H is a space of motivated multiple databases. And this Hopf algebra can be viewed as a ring of linear function of prime potent part of mixed motivic Gara group of mixed eight motifs over G. So anyway, I will denote it by G. It's a fine group scheme of Hopf algebra A, and its graded linear algebra is denoted by A. This is called motivic linear algebra, and it is known that by Brown. So this Z algebra is isomorphic to 3D algebra generated by sigma 3, sigma 5, sigma 7, index 5 of the integer greater than or equal to 3. This element is called zeta element, and it is embedded into Z algebra in x0 and x1 with Ihara bracket. Giving explicit formula for zeta element in terms of the element in x0, x1 is very important problem. Actually, it is equivalent to finding all linear relation among motivic multiple zeta values. And so far we know that this one is the depth one component is given by this D element, and we don't know for higher depth terms. So I will use this element, canonical depth one component later. So I will denote it by sigma 2i plus 1, 1. So now I'm going to the depth three relation. So we denote by D sub R of H the space of motivic MDVs of depth less than or equal to R. So this is a filtration on the space of motivic multiple zeta bytes, and this induces a filtration on the quotient space H, Hopf algebra A. So, and now we define the, we will consider the affine group scheme of graded Hopf algebra of A. So, the graded with respect to the depth, and denote Gay-Berg with graded linear algebra. This is called depth graded motivic linear algebra. So in contrast with motivic linear algebra, we don't know the structure of K bar. There is a conjecture by Brown. So this linear algebra, depth graded motivic linear algebra, is isomorphic to the linear algebra generated by a canonical depth one component, depth one element, so each of integer, 2i plus 1, and a certain cuspidal generator in depth 4 obtained from the period polynomials. Actually, restricted even period polynomials. And these generators are subject only to the quadratic relation, which comes from Ihara Takao relation. So this is a kind of overview of the previous works, and maybe if you are interested in influences from paper, that's graded and the D. It's okay. Okay, so okay, now what is totally optimal for this algorithm? Roughly speaking, we are looking for the corresponding object to the D algebra generated by depth one component, depth one canonical generator. So more precisely, the problem is to find a sub Hopf algebra of a odd graded a odd of Hopf algebra of graded Hopf algebra of A such that its graded Lie algebra, so Lie algebra is defined by in this way, so take affine group scheme and take Lie algebra, so it is denoted by J odd, is isomorphic to the algebra generated by just one component. So assuming his conjecture, Brown's conjecture, we can compute the dimension of the space. This one, so actually, it's generating series is given by this one, graded depth A odd of weight n part. So the subscript always means the weight, and the depths are. N by this out is equal to 1 kilogram minus OX Y plus SX Y square. The usual notation for the Brodhaus-Kreimer conjecture, OX is X cubed over 4 minus X square, and SX is generating series of the dimension of the space of Kasparov. So what's the corresponding object? What's this? What's the subspace of the graded Hopf algebra A? So, and Brown suggested that this A odd is given by totally odd multiple zeta values. So this is multiple multiple zeta values at the sequences indexed by odd integer greater than or equal to 3, modulo the ideal generated by zeta 2, and modulo row vertex. So this is an element in related A. Actually, we can check numerically the dimension on the right-hand side space agrees with this expression. So for example, we can check that the dimension of the say, spanned by totally odd double zeta values. It's equal to O x squared minus S x. And in the case step 3, we get O cubed minus 2 times O s. For zeta values, and this minus space minus 1 counts the number of relations. So roughly speaking, totally odd multiple zeta values satisfy the relation which may be obtained from the cusp form. So this is a okay, so that's a totally odd multiple zeta values. So in what follow we yes. So I should something in the case of depth 2. We already know the equality in the case of depth 2. I mean the dimension. This follows from the result of Gandel-Kanekos idea. They actually gave an explicit linear relation on totally odd double zeta values using this using period polynomial. So I will come back to this topic later. But in the case of depth 3, we don't know this equality, but numerically we can check this equality.
Isn't an inequality known in one direction?
Oh, yes, we know the inequality, yes. Thank you. Now I'm going to prepare some key ingredients. In order to deal with these kind of problems. So one of them is Brown's operator. So it is for positive integer, for odd positive integer greater than 1, we define a map from the space of motivic multiple zeta values of weight n to Ln tensor Hn minus m, where L is a space modulo product. So I will not define this operator precisely because we need to introduce motivic iterated integral. But we can refer Stephen's talk 2 weeks ago. He already defined it. So I will skip this.
Do you want M odd?
M odd, sorry, yes. Thank you. M should be odd. Yes, as Stephen explained, this operator is quite useful because we have the following theorem. So again, Brown. So the kernel of the sum of Brown's operator up to weight n is rational multiple of single zeta values. So this theorem is quite useful because this gives kind of criterion whether linear combination of motivic multiple zeta values over weight n is less than a multiple of single zeta values or not. So computing DM is very important. And now I'm going to give a formula for the multi-peak multiple zeta value under the map DM. So for this we introduce the following integers. So we define the integer e indexed by positive integer m1 to through ml, n1 to nl, by this one, plus here, Kronecker, so this delta is just Kronecker delta. So this one is 1 if the first line is equal to the second line, otherwise 0. So this integer is just a sum of binomial coefficient. It's a very easy object.
Second line is kind of surprising. M1,
yeah,
and mi. In the delta, you removed m in the first line, you've got m2 up to mi.
Yes, m2 from starting from m2.
Yeah, and the next line you've remitted ni.
And yeah, we need this substraft ni. This integer gives a kind of a leading term of the formula for the multi-peak multiple zeta value under the map DM. So this is a proposition. For positive integers, n1 to nr is the one with weight n. The element the sum of this one minus L tensor R and this R minus 2 part. So this is the statement. So where zeta L is an image of multi-peak single zeta values in the module product. Okay. So depths are motivic merged for zeta bias, dm preserves depths. So therefore, this proposition tells you that the higher depth term of the formula is given by this coefficient. So this one is depth r, and this one is depth 1, and depth r minus 1. So this one is a higher depth term in the formula of d of dm. Yeah, of course, the dm, the operator dm is very explicit. So we can compute the lower depth terms as well. But this small piece of information is enough for our purpose. Actually, we have a nice application. So in computing Brown isomorphism, so by as a result of, as a consequence of Brown's result, we have an isomorphism, non-canonical isomorphism between motivic multiple zeta and certain formal alpha generated by symbol F2F plus 1 and tensor QF2 commutative polynomial variable. So this is non-canonical, but we can normalize this map as a single zeta value mapping to the single symbol F. So for if n is odd, then this is very defined, but when n equal to even, like 4, 6, we should define the element F to k. So this is given by this formula. The application is we can compute this isomorphism explicitly. So the state of correlate, the image of motivic double zeta values under the map phi is given by the sum of E M1, M2, M1, M2 times F M1, F M2 plus a single F with some rational coefficient. So from this proposition, we can determine the higher length term, length two terms in the formula under the map phi. So the coefficient is given by E, just I defined before. But with this proposition, we can't determine this part. So we should do some extra work to determine this coefficient. But so thanks to Niels yesterday's talk, we can use this notation. Actually, the coefficient can be given by the solution to the double Schaeffler equation in depth 2. So this satisfies the double Schaeffler equation in depth 2. Yeah, and it's called Bernoulli realization, constructed by Gundel Kanizel. Yeah, this is the case in depth 2. So we can continue on this computation for higher depths. And it, for example, in the case of depth 3, the leading coefficient plus some lower length term. By this one there. So from this formula, you can see some inductive structure of the coefficient of higher length terms in the image of under the Mach 3. So actually, we can continue this computation for any depth. So this is key ingredient in this study. Yeah, actually, in the proof, we should use the fact that the Mach P is isomorphic as algebra cohomology. We should use some complicated diagram, but I will omit this part. So, okay. Now I'm going to talk about totally automatic zeta of this. So it's denoted by I sub n r, the set of total of indices of weight n and its r. So this is a set of total indices.
For any sums, the mi's are odd.
Yes.
So the weight is even. Or are you looking at the totally odd case?
So this is general case. I mean, we don't need to restrict our...
Yeah, the MIs need to be odd in this formula.
Ah, yeah, in the right-hand side, yeah. Yes, I didn't find it. The case weight even. The case weight even, namely N1 plus N2 is even, then N1 and N2 are greater than or equal to 3 because of the isomorphic phi. Yes, phi. So, but in the case of weight odd, we have parity, so f odd and f even appear. Mm-hmm. But yeah, we can. We have this kind of form for a weight. So I'm going. Let's turn to totally odd case. In this case, I already list that you can see this for me. In this case, I mean the case when N1 to N0 are totally odd indices, then this part is the same, but N1 and NR runs over totally odd indices. Somehow, so the Brown's operator preserves totally oddness for the higher depth part. So, and because of these properties, we will. This is a matrix whose coefficient is given by C. C is a coefficient of Fm1 dot dot Fmr higher length terms in phi theta Fn1 dot Fmr. So we can compute this C explicitly. And laws and quorum are indexed by totally odd indices. So this is just square matrix. Size I n r. Express this matrix as a product of the matrix whose coefficient given by E. So for this, C and R is something written as the product of certain matrix. So what's this matrix C? For this matrix C, C and R, we have the following conjecture by Brown, okay? So take linear combination of displayed motivic multiple zeta values. At totally of indices of weight n and weight r, which lies in the lower depth sounds. This is if and only if the low vector given by the coefficient by total of indices gives like annihilator of this matrix C and R. So consider any linear combination which lies in the lower depth term, then the coefficient are given by the light annihilator of matrix C and R. So this is a conjecture, but we can prove this conjecture up to depth 3. And in the case of depth 2 and depth 3, the light annihilator always gives linear relation among totally odd multiple zeta values. So the proof is not so difficult if you have explicit formula under the map V. So let me briefly sketch the proof. So first we take light annihilator of matrix C and Q. So this is by the formula equal to En 2, 2. And this is the matrix of the coefficient B. Depth 2. Assume that the low vector is light annihilator of this matrix C and 2. Then what then consider its linear combination. And take isomorphism phi, then we can easily see that this is rational multiple of single f. So because of the formula, so we call phi modulic and 1 and 2 is given by sum of e m1 m2 and 1 and 2 f m1 f m2 plus something. So this linear combination kills higher rank terms. So therefore we get this statement, and by the normalization this is rational multiple of single beta values. Therefore this linear combination gives this linear combination is a rational multiple of single zeta bytes. So this is last sketch of the proof of depth 2 case. And depth 3 case, we can also do the same game. But in the case of depth 3, the light annihilator of matrix CN3 kills length 3 terms, and we also have lower length terms, length 2 and length 1. And we should check that lower terms is a pre-image of the space of double zeta values under the map phi. We can prove it up to depth 3, but we cannot prove in the case of r equal to 4, because the depth 3 iteration is not compatible with length 3 iteration of the former algebra in F. So in what follow we consider the matrix E and R R. So this matrix is in some sense essential. And in the case of depth 2, this matrix is studied by Bomard and Schneps. I will first recall the result. They show that the left annihilator is given by the left restricted even period polynomial, and the right annihilator gives a Gandur-Kanekozagi relation. So, roughly speaking, left annihilator of this matrix is equal to the, in some sense, isomorphic to the space of restricted even period polynomial. This is a polynomial of homogeneous degree n minus 2, n should be given, satisfying this equation. Y. Plus more with the assumption PXY is even and the higher degree part is we have this result. And for the light annihilator, we know that this one is given by certain low vector, which is obtained from restricted even field polynomial. So like the annihilator gives a linear relation among totally of the double zeta pairs, and this relation is coincided with so-called Gandur-Kanakozami relation, or short relation. So they gave new interpretation of the Gandur-Kanakozami relation using this matrix. Main result of this talk is kind of generalization of the statement, the above statement, so that for the left annihilator of the matrix in town. So this is main theorem. We should define the extended period polynomial, not the extended. So let W and R be the space of polynomial of the form such that P satisfies restrict periodic polynomial relation for the first two variables. So it's kind of tensor, this is just tensor with tensor of WK even 0, tensor, just normal, just free variable. Yeah, I will only finish it. But we do not assume any relation for other variable, except for first and second variable. Okay, so for this W and L, we have the following map. So maybe statement not clear. Then the map, the linear map, this one is well defined. This is a statement. Thank you. So I just proved verb definiteness, namely for the element in W and L, take the coefficient and the merge prime this matrix from left. So I and L is just a matrix, identity matrix of total of indices. Merge prime this matrix from right, we get element in the kernel. So I'm going to give you an example. The first non-trivial example is in weight 15 and weight 3. So in this space we have the famous element. Here and for this, applying this matrix, multiplying this matrix from right, we get 1 minus 18, 15, 8, 0 minus 42, minus 28, minus 42, 42, 37 in common. So yes, and in this case the dimension is 1, so every element is less than a multiple of this one. So in some sense this theorem tells you a characterization of the left annihilator of matrix E and R using restricted E period polynomial. So and actually I have conjectured. So the map here, low and R, something like this. The map low and R is isometric. Every left annihilator of the matrix E and R is given by this way, from the restricted even period polynomial. So, yeah, we have few progress on this conjecture, but I will skip this part. Instead, I will remark about the light annihilator. So the matrix, the light annihilator of this matrix gives a linear relation number totally of merge to zeta bodies. And what's this? So is given by maybe many people are interested in the generalization of Ganguly-Kani-Kozagi addition, and maybe this one is the first candidate of the generalization of Ganguly-Kani-Kozagi addition to depth 3. So namely, this is homework for everybody. So characterize these integers using the coefficient of restricted even period of polynomial. So define, construct the map, construct linear map from W and R to the light annihilator of E and R. So this is still open. Thank you.
But you tried.
I did. Yeah, I tried, but yeah, how do I try? Yeah, well, yeah. New section. So, yeah, I didn't state Gandhi Kanekozagi relation, but you'll see later. For any task form, we define the even period polynomial as the generating series of generating polynomial of critical values of their function of custom. Even part of usual periodic polynomial. So it's just a remark. Now and then we can state our result. This is a joint project with Dilma for any cast form define complex number Q sub O S by the coefficient of this Lassonian transformation of even pure polynomial. So since PF even is just a generating polynomial of the critical values of the function of f, so QOS is just a linear combination of critical values of the function of f at odd integer point. At odd integer point. Yeah. So then we have okay. The sum of this one, where R plus S equals to K and R and S are greater than or equal to 1 and O is equal to 0. Yeah, actually, so I didn't define the multiple zeta values. Now I should care about it. So in my notation, so the last component should be greater than or equal to Q for convergence. So therefore, so S should be greater than or equal to 3, but we can prove that Q minus 1, 1 is 0. Yeah, but of course we can say this should be good for sake. Thank you. proof, I may use explicit formula of motivic mark double beta byte and the mark C. So I will briefly sketch the proof. So of course we use motivic multiple beta values. We trace zeta to motivic double zeta values and take phi isomorphism and use the result Homer and synapse. Then we can check that coefficient of length 2 term vanishes. Therefore, reminder is to prove foreign crane. Ah, yeah. So my zeta q uses a different normalization with Newton's one. Maybe I should tilde. So in Newton's talk, he defined single solution, a single data value in the rational one. I don't know how to say it. It's a kind of Bernoulli number, but in this case, we choose this normalization. Yeah, anyway, so.
And also different order.
Yeah, different order, yeah, thank you. And this one comes from Conan's idea to result. They proved an extra relation among critical values of a function of f. Using the orthogonality of Kasparov and eigenvectors. So there is a Haber-Lang formula which expresses Peterson inner product of two Kasparov as a linear combination of two product of critical values of a function. And Kohn and Zagier generalized their result for modular form. And the formula is exactly the same as this one. But we also have some extra term. But this term we can check by using period polynomial relation, namely two cycle relation and three cycle relation. We can check this is zero by using two cycle and three cycle relation. So yeah, this is a proof.
Can you interpret this coefficient in terms of period polynomial?
Which one?
So the number sum QRS. Does it have some? Can it be read off simply from the period polynomial? Using Hecke operators or something?
Oh, I see.
I want to see the 3,617
691.
Yeah. Is there a recipe to get this coefficient of the single zeta directly from the period polynomial?
Yeah, actually, I don't know. You know. can we express this number as Hecke operator or? Yeah. I don't know, yeah. Anyway, yeah, this linear translation is really strange. Yeah, but it appeared in the formula of Kohn and Zagier. So, but I don't know how to explain this linear translation. naturally. Okay, so yeah, I can stop here. Yeah, I will stop here. Yeah. Thank you very much.
So when you write this matrix C as a product of matrices E, so what happens is, do you expect the kernel of C to be just given by one of the E's, or do the image of each E map into the kernel of the next map in some complicated way?
For the left-hand analysis of the matrix C, and now we can completely, we have conjectural description. So kernel C and R is given by periodic polynomial like this one. So this 1 and 2 implies where we assume periodic polynomial relation for the variable. So this one is first two variables satisfied period polynomial. This one satisfied for the second and third variable satisfied period polynomial. And after we prove this inclusion, this is a work in progress with Dinman.
And you mean the sum instead of union? These are vector
union,
spaces?
Yes,
yeah.
Union.
Union, or because they're vector spaces, you mean?
Sum, yes, vector spaces, yes. So we should count the intersection, but we can do it.
Oh, they have non-trivial.
Yes, there is non-trivial intersection.
Are there more questions?
So it's a refinement in the sense, so you call it a refinement of Galilean-Kanikos relation, because you can give them statement about the coefficients of zeta.
Which
they don't.
So, and the Galilean-Kanikos relation, they ignore the higher degree term, I don't know how to say. Yeah, it's kind of a boundary part. So they first model this part and then take this. We get a relation modulus in the universe. But this, we don't need to take a module.
So does that mean that the coefficient of the odd zeta comes directly from the coefficient of the covariant?
Yeah.
Is there, to my earlier question, as well, that there's a formula?
Yes. So okay. We can write it explicitly.
Oh, you can write it explicitly. Okay.
Yeah. Using the period. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So then, thank you for speaking again.